Well, here I am back checking out that area that Randy Barnes and I checked out the other day, but this is a really big place, and I came in from a completely different entrance, so I don't really know what I'm going to find, although I've been told there is stuff to see in here. So we're going to go for a little hike and see what we run across. All right, so continuing on, and I just saw something here. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Does that look familiar or what? I've been told there's a lot of structures and stuff of that nature in here, so. Here comes a playful pup chasing the birds. Anyway, let's see where this goes. Well, I have to be honest, I'm about 20 minutes in. I've seen a few signs of them. Now, maybe I've come in the wrong entrance. I guess there's a few, but I don't know. But anyway, there's something. So they are around. Well, continue on my walk and see what I can find. I mean, okay. Here we go. Well, I mean, I already had it confirmed from the last time I was in here. I don't even know which way I came in that there is Sasquatch in here, but yeah, this isn't much, but look at all the sticks leaned up against that stuff. Typical Sasquatch stuff. Yeah. Well, there's not much to look at, but if you can just jump up there. I'm, whew, I took my breath away. I was, anyway, does this look like a trail to you? Does this look like a trail to you? Not to me. I'm going to reenact what happened. I'm going to go back here. This was, wow. I'm not shook up because, well, the forest people are spiritual people. I mean, I'm not shook up. I'm just like, man, holy crap, was that cool. So, no, seriously, I mean, they could walk up and shake my hand and I'd be okay with it, the way I feel connected to them at this point. But, you know, what I'm basically wanting to convey is that I am very, very excited because I was just walking up here, right around here, and right where I was pointing in, just over here, I saw a black figure walk into the bush. All black, get a great glimpse of it, but I'm 100% sure it was humanoid and it was all black. I didn't see any clothes on it, and it walked off into here and I ran. Well, I didn't run, I'm trying to be disrespectful, but I covered that distance kind of fast because I really wanted to see, because I knew it was something weird, and I thought at first, is that a human? And then, wait a minute, because I didn't see the person come out, so. No. I just saw a Sasquatch in here, guys. Very, very cool. And I saw a little sign back there. Maybe that was the greeting, and maybe this is the way they want me to go. Awesome. Awesome. Wow. That warms my heart. That is such a blessing. Such an honor. Oh my God. buddy. I'm just kind of reflecting on that sighting I just had. There's absolutely no doubt it was a sighting. Humanoid figure, all black. But like I said, the kicker is that I was there like right away where I saw it walking. And I thought, you know, from my vantage point, you know, dozen yards or so back, well, maybe 20 yards. I thought, well, maybe there's a trail there. But then I got up there pretty darn quick. And no trail, absolutely. And it was kind of thick foliage and no way. Hi. Absolutely no way that that was a person. Couldn't be. Just could not have walked off in that area and been or disappeared virtually by the time I got there. You know, plus all black, didn't see any clothes. Wow. Very cool, very cool. Holy crap, I'm being hit up with the energy now. Whoa. And look at this. Oh, mud there. Check this out. That is cool. Yeah. Okay. Still haven't really calmed down yet, but looks like I'm on the right trail now. Check this out. Here's a little structure. You know, it happened so quick, the Sasquatch I just saw that walked off the trail. You know, there's not even any question that it was a Sasquatch. I mean, it had to be, you know, as I've explained. But I just wanted to add that it didn't look to be very old or very big. Probably, maybe my height, I don't know. You know, I didn't see it for long. I just know what I saw. But, like it wasn't RE size or anything, that's for sure. So, hey, let's carry on. I guess we're starting to find some of the stuff. Cool, cool, cool. Here I am. Well, I can't read a map. I think when I look at a map, left is right and right is left. I don't know what's going on. But anyway, this day is getting very, very interesting. So, you know, I've seen a structure or two. I haven't seen the bountiful that I've been told about, but that's fine. Had a sighting. Got that energy thing. Like, it was just amazing. And check this out. Here is Brian and Sue's glyph. Here's our fish glyph. Now, it's got some big ends on it, but still, that's the fish glyph, no doubt about it. Now, this is like 50 miles or so away from my area, so, well, like I've always said, when they know you one place, they know you everywhere. Now, they may not always like you, but they're going to know you and they're going to respect you. Hey, fella, how you doing? How you doing? Yeah. That sighting was so cool. It was just so cool. And then the greeting with the glove for Susan and I, and that energy, it was like,
when I woke this morning,
I guess
something
I'm walking
inside
around
of
these
me
guys.
Told me this would be my day. I heard the morning train, I felt the wind change. Too many times I'm on my way. Come on, sunshine, what can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? Well, the wind can shake me, brothers forsake me, the rain can touch me.
You know, sightings, at least up in these parts, and from my experience and from people I know and whatever, they don't happen very often up here. You know, other areas like in Georgia and whatever, some of those campouts there. You know, it seems to be a different story. But in any event, yeah, that was amazing. And, you know, I'd like to revise what I said earlier because I've been thinking, wow, check this forest out. Check this out. Just beautiful. Anyway, you know, I was saying maybe up to 20 yards he was away. I think he was closer than that. I think he was probably within 12 yards, like I initially said. He was very close. Close enough so that, you know, there was no mistaking what I was saying. He was very close. It was brief, though, like I said. But absolutely no question what I saw. There's no other explanation for it. And, yeah. Just amazing. Yeah. Beautiful forest here. So I think see what we can come across. I think we're gonna come across some stuff in a bit. So let's just see how that goes. Through the woods, and you know, I'm terrible with reading maps. I just got some directions on how to read a map from a gentleman, and well, I still don't trust that I'm going the right way, but I guess we'll find out. Oh, what do we have here?
Come on.
But I guess we'll find out, and oh, that guy's quick. He looks like not a border collie. What am I thinking? Australian Shepherd or something? Or, I'm not sure. Something like that. Anyway, I'm still not sure I'm going the right way, but it's funny how friendlier people are and life seems more normal when you're out in the woods. Almost like nothing's changed. I guess there's a positive message in that. But anyway, let's see if I'm going the right way. Okay, I'm walking along the trail here, and yeah, this looks very, very familiar. This was obviously an old structure. It's fallen apart. You can see the, I guess that's the evergreen branches there, and the ferns and all that stuff, and all the pieces of wood all kind of fall into the ground. But yeah, that definitely looks like an old structure that's falling apart. Well, let's continue on. This place is cool. I mean, my God. I've only been here twice. First time with Randy Barnes, and that was an amazing time, just seeing all the structures and everything. And this time with my sighting and just the communication between us, that was the thing that I thought was really that I thought was the most amazing and meant the most to me, is the direct communication between me and this clan. The them leaving me the Sioux and Brian glyph just spoke wonders. So I'm very grateful for that. Hey guys, I'm not even sure how much I want to share this, and I don't know how much I believe it. You know, I'm pretty pragmatic, considering the experiences I've had. It might sound crazy, but it's the truth. But, you know, Sue and I and myself and at times have seen some strange things. Like one time we were camping way back in the woods by a stream, and there was this big huge rock where we were camping, and we saw a face in there that just looked so much like a Sasquatch. And I'll find the picture and I'll put it in this video, and it was amazing. And then, you know, I went back there sometime after that, and like that face was not in that rock, and it was like dramatic to like what happened. So I can't explain it, and I don't know, you know, I don't know how much of this is pareidolia or whatever, but I'm looking at this stump here. I just came upon this. This is magical. Like, I mean, this is a magical day. The sighting is one thing. Now, this part might be a leap of faith, but for me, it struck a chord. So I'm looking at this, and I'm looking at the stump here, and I'm looking at it, and I see, look, there's a Sasquatch face looking at me. And it, I mean, looks so obvious. So then I walk around here and I look at this over here, and I'm looking at it, and it looks like a guy standing there. A single Sasquatch guy. There was some energy with it, so it was kind of neat. I don't know what to make of it, but it's been certainly a magical day, you know, like pareidolia. I don't know. Interesting though. No, you know, I think pareidolia comes into play, but I think with a lot of these things, with people who are on a higher vibrational level or whatever, and that doesn't mean better or worse, it's just that they're vibrating on a closer level to nature, or the Sasquatch people, or that frequency, or whatever. Okay, well, this is more like it. Awesome. Yeah, check this out. Wow, there's some big pieces in there. That's very much like the one Randy Barnes and I ran across the first time we were here. Interesting. Very interesting. I wonder what that design means, because it's very similar to the, like I said, the one Randy Barnes and I saw. I'm not sure what it means. Okay. Very interesting. Oh. Hi. Thank you. so, you know, obviously Sasquatch don't do everything I come across or we come across. I mean, you know, I've been fooled before. I'm sure we all have, and I'm not afraid to admit it because, you know, I'm not trying to prove Sasquatch exists. I know they exist. Got a connection with them, so, you know, just trying to understand them, share their wisdom. So if something, you know, like a structure, for instance, or a tractor turns out to be human, that's fine. Doesn't change anything. But anyway, enjoying this walk today, and I just wanted to point out some of the interesting little things that you might want to pay attention to if, you know, you're out in a boat. And subtle little things like this. Now, see this stump here? Now, this snap little piece here is just kind of placed in there. As a matter of fact, there's two, and there's one with moss. You know, as far as I'm concerned, those were placed there. Now, they don't really stand out, but when you know what you're looking for, you know, it gives you something to pay attention to, and it gives you some signs if our friends are around or whatever. But I mean, as far as I'm concerned, those didn't fall from up there. And you know, there's a tight little space in between that little branch, kind of root thing growing out. So no, those were placed there. So just kind of interesting things to pay attention to. My steps here. So I was walking along the main road, sort of meandering my way back to my car, checking things out, and I got an urge to go off path, or off trail I should say, and I followed this. And you know, well, pay attention to those inklings or whatever. So I'm retracing my steps. So check out this amazing glyph here. I mean, wow. The long curve piece goes actually back, all the way back over to here, but yeah, I like the main meat of it right there. That's an amazing glyph. You know, I've never seen anything exactly like that one in my area. Now, what we're going to come across next is just going to blow your mind. It blew my mind. This is sensational stuff. So let's continue on. Like I say, I'm backtracking. Tracing my steps. So that glyph was very, very cool.
Before the winter chill, we used to go a-cotton long up to the hill, and she could laugh away the dark clouds.
So retracing my steps back, this is the second thing I came across. Look at this big circular thing, and this is the thing that I haven't mentioned in some of my other videos that I forgot to mention that I find really, really intriguing is, you know, all the curvature of all these sticks. You know, it's forming some kind of circle thing. But, you know, the majority, well, just about all of the sticks have got a pretty good curve to them. Where do they find all those? You know, there's some, but I'd say the vast majority of them are just straight. But anyway, look at that. Look at that. That's cool. And then this next thing, I'm going to give it away before we get up to it. It's just spectacular. I've never seen anything quite like it. I've seen some spectacular stuff. This one ranks right up there. Look at that. Look at it. Oh my God. Look how it goes from here and all around and like, wow. And once again, all those curved sticks. Now, you know, you can never just, well, whatever, I mean. I guess you can never discount people for some of these things, and people have made them, but it's the consistency of some of these things. And I mean, look at the work put into that, those curved sticks. Where do you find all those around here? Yeah, there's sticks everywhere, but that's a lot of work, anyway. And what does it mean? I'd like some thoughts on what that one means. Just so amazingly cool. Yeah, like I was just compelled to come off the main road. You guys know how that works. And find all this stuff I would have never found if that inkling hadn't gotten into my head. So, my God, that's amazing. Very, very cool glove. I've never seen anything quite like it. This thing back here. The circle thing. Absolutely amazing. And then, well, this thing is just in a whole other world of amazing. Yeah, check that out. Yeah. Something else, my friends. This has been one amazing day. Sighting. Found some amazing, the structure's not so much, because, well, I haven't seen a lot of them. And because I've seen so many structures, it would be hard. Well, they're all amazing, so I'm not going to say that. But the ground things I found, like this, and that other circle, just in behind it, some of those things, and you know, a few of the glyphs have been pretty frigging outstanding, right up there with the best of the best. So this is cool. Very cool indeed. Wow. Here's something interesting. I don't know if you guys have heard about conchs. Some of them grow extremely large. I mean, they're huge, and they grow on old stumps and stuff and sides of trees. And here's one that's actually really, really, really small. But I've never seen this. Right underneath it, like little newborn conchs. That is cool. And like I said, the one up on top of it is pretty small too. Those are like, wow. Seedlings? I don't know what you would call them. Interesting, though. Never seen the little guys like that, just starting out in life. Yeah, that was extremely interesting, that ring thing, like a maze or something. Well, yeah, what a day. This is extremely compelling right here. You know that XA glyph? Well, you don't have to know it. I'll show it to you in the video. But, you know, I've always said that, you know, around a lot of these things or whatever, there's collaborative evidence, which doesn't necessarily mean that the Sasquatch made everything or even that they made the major thing you're looking at. But what it does mean is that they have been around. And, you know, we all know that they make these things, so it makes it somewhat more compelling, but does not eliminate human involvement. So, you know, just to make that clear. But anyway, that XA glyph was actually just back there, and I won't retrace my steps that far back, because I'm not really sure exactly how far back it was. But anyway, so, okay, so I'm walking along, and look at this. Okay, classic friendship welcome act, right? I think, okay, that's cool. Then I get up here and check this out. I mean, oh my Lord. Look at all those sticks stuck in there. Yeah, could be human. But you know, a couple glyphs right by. I've seen a Sasquatch in here. And you know, other interesting stuff like this fern here. This is not growing in there, it was placed in there. That's something I see the Sasquatch do all the time, so. You know, just little compelling bits of evidence that you find around some of these. I mean, look at it from this angle. Burnt out tree too. Wow. And I bet you as soon as I turn this camera off, I'm gonna find something else. Oh yes, 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 yes. Yes. Earlier, I found a big Y. This one's not quite as big, and this is at a different entrance to this place, but check it out. So, you know, you kind of put it together, like, here's the Y. Couple glyphs down here. This thing here, you know, the fern stuck in there. Something I see all the time. And then, of course, these. Well, is it all Sasquatch? I'm not sure. Has Sasquatch been here? Yeah. Absolutely. So, just some of the stuff to look for. Well, continuing along and kind of lost in my thoughts about my sighting and the energy and those amazing glyphs I found and whatever, and yeah, look at this. Very nice. Very nice. What an area. Reminds me very, very much of my area. I know Sue, when she sees this, will think the same thing. Very, very similar. Yeah, just amazing. Just amazing. Blessed to live in this place. And, you know, blessed to have been taken under the wing of the Sasquatch people as a student or however one would want to look at it. But it's a beautiful journey and, wow. Amazing journey. Thank you very much. These urges to go way off trail, and this time I'm not backtracking. I see something from a distance, so let's go up and discover what this is together. Yeah, I'm just getting these urges, so to speak, to go off trail and discovering all these amazing things. So, oh boy, this is pretty darn cool. Wow. And there is an awful lot of work to this one, boys and girls. Awful lot of work to that one. What the heck? Check it out a little further. No discernible entrance or anything. Interesting. But look at the massive amount of work in there. Hmm. wondering. There's always something else around. Okay, well, I see something over here. Now, once again, for me, structures and rock stacks are probably the most inexact science when we're dealing with our Sasquatch friends. That said, I'm firmly entrenched in the belief, well, I know they make both, put it that way. But, so do people, so there's always that, but yeah, but look at this over here. Rock stack now. To me, look at this for a second now, in relation to, say this is just over here. I don't think there's much question about who made that. But if this indeed is Sasquatch made and not people made, and like I said, I'm a ways off trail, but if it is Sasquatch made, like I said, then I would say that would probably represent five clan members with the Big Daddy on the bottom and five of them all together. That would be my read on that. There we have that structure. My battery went dead. I just noticed something amazing. Something very, 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 well, pretty much the same thing as I found in another place. So, you know, as I was saying, quite often you find collaborative evidence. Now the rocks, well, whatever. Might be, may not be. It's too hard to say. But I mean, it is around in an area where they're doing their stuff. And then look at this. Another one of these circles. What in the heck? Once again, all those round sticks. This one's way off trail. Funny, you know, once again, compelled to come in here. Like I was compelled to come to that other one. Found those wild circles. And now this. Oh man, this is so cool. I'm gonna walk around here a little more because I'm finding more and more stuff in here. Look at that. Isn't that something? Wow. Let's go stand in that circle. Yeah, here I am in the circle. Oh yeah, look at that. Friendship welcome back. At least that's what it means for me with my clan. But notice how that's extending into the circle. Well, I am going to walk around here for a few minutes and then I guess I'm gonna head to another area. Wrap it up at some point. But yeah, what an amazing day. Oh my good Lord. Well, I've already found one fish cliff for Sue and I. My goodness, look at this. Look at that. You know, the communication and the potential of communication between ourselves and them, you know, even on this rudimentary level through the glyphs, like I'm experiencing and evolving and growing in, is amazing. And it's way deeper than that, but I'm just saying that a connection between yourself and the Sasquatch people is, it just never ceases to amaze. And this has been one of those magical days that has just been beyond amazing. Another one of the fish cliffs for Sue and I. Thank you guys. I can't even express words. Thank you so much. Wow. Hey guys, I can't even express words. I'm just retracing my steps. I just walked by here and I didn't see this on the way by. It might have been, so I'm not going to say it wasn't. But regardless, whether it just showed up, within the last few minutes, or whatever the case may be, it's the third Brian and Sue glyph. And, my God. Look, it's got the Friendship Welcome X in it. And you know, it looks like Friendship Welcome has also got an A in there. I mean, wow, that's the third one. Or is it an A? No, it's not quite touching, I'm not sure. But it's definitely the fish glove. The third one, I mean, what a, wow, this is remarkable. I can't even express the words. It's remarkable. Wow. Okay, so I'm retracing my steps here. I saw a few glyphs. I'm just headed out and so I'd take this last little trail that's kind of away from the regular beaten path. And yeah, it looks like they've been hanging around this one for sure. Pretty cool glyph there. Let's see what we got here. Quite the day, actually, you know. Any day that you get to see one of the Forest Brothers, it's a blessing, that's for sure. Saw some other stuff. But anyway, very cool day. Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go. Yeah, so they're walking around down in here. Incredible. So I'm just going to go a little bit further and then I'll have to come back and explore another day. The trail is getting pretty soggy and washed out here. Yeah, not gonna go that way. It's like the legend of Bogey Creek over there. Except I don't think that they portrayed that Forest Brother as a brother so much. One of those four-story depictions of them as monsters, I think, if I recall, but I can't remember the exact plot for that one, but most of them don't seem to show them the respect that they deserve as spiritual denizens of the forest, protectors of the forest, spiritual teachers, gentle, loving, high vibrational beings, so. Hopefully more and more people will understand that and try to become that way themselves. I think that's the way of the conscious shift or whatever people want to call it. Right there. That's the old key in the secret or not secret right there. Anyway, great day. Very grateful to have made the acquaintance of some new forest people. And yeah, I will be back and visit them again. So I'd like to add a little more detailed description of what I saw. As I said, the figure I saw was probably about a dozen yards in front of me, directly in front of me on the path. Now the path may be, I don't know, 12 feet across or whatever. But interestingly enough, very much like when I saw Forshna, when he appeared out of thin air when he was crossing the path many years prior, I did not see this figure until it was maybe 2 or 3 yards away from where it walked off the trail. And what I saw exactly is I did not see a head. Not much of the legs. I basically just saw the torso. But it was all black. And you know how Patty has the arm swings? She's walking along, she's swinging her arms. I saw a couple swings of the arms back and forth. And then it was off the trail and disappeared. And like I said, I was upon it within moments. The chances of it being a human being? Zero. And that's not even wishful thinking. A zero. Unless it was a human being that just disappeared into thin air, which, well, in a way it was. And reiterating my earlier point, as far as size goes, I would say the individual to me appeared to be perhaps a juvenile or a female, perhaps 6-7 feet. But, you know, I got a very, very brief glimpse of it. What I saw is undeniable. I know what I saw, but I didn't see it long enough to get an estimate of size, other than to say it wasn't our resize. Hey, everybody. Had a day to rehash my thoughts a little bit on my sighting yesterday. And just wanted to kind of go over them in case I missed out a few, or to just put them in a concise kind of package. But, I think for the most part, at least with people who are going to have a connection with Sasquatch at some point, or have a connection with Sasquatch, obviously, it's even more obvious. But most encounters are not random. And obviously my encounter yesterday was not random, for a number of reasons. Now, in some cases, they can be random. I mean, there's been so many reports of Sasquatch crossing a road and the expression on his face of, like, shock to see somebody there. So, I mean, it can be random, but in many, many, many cases, it's not random. It's by design. This was one such case, obviously. And one of the really, really strong points that I wanted to make about it is that, obviously they wanted to connect with me there. It was a very, very strong welcome. I mean, the energy I felt was amazing. Just absolutely amazing after that sighting. And then them leaving me three for sure, of the Sue and Brian glyphs. Those are very specific glyphs. There's nothing random about them. And for me to find three of them in conjunction with the events that went on there, the sighting, the energy, the connection, the welcome, the introduction, all that stuff, for me to find three of them in conjunction with that in an area that's probably 60 miles or so away from my area, speaks of something much, much greater than randomness. I mean, the chance of that being random, the probability of that is astronomical. It just really speaks of the connection and over distance, and the authenticity of this connection between experiencers and the Sasquatch, in whatever way that connection is facilitated. My case through, through MindSpeak, energy, thought placement, blah, 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 glyphs. Other people, their mixed bag of how they connect, So it really speaks of that, that they left me one of the most special glyphs, my glyph of Susan and myself, our connection, that they left that there in conjunction with the amazing, beautiful thing that transpired there, just took it up another whole notch. And the other thing that was really, really fascinating is that, we always have to consider that some, you know, people do ceremonies and whatever in some of these places. Like, this place is not a place where people camp, but I can't say for sure that people don't make some of these circles and stuff. I mean, it's an inexact science with some of the structures and some of these things. Sasquatch definitely make them. They make a lot of them. I'm not even confident of that. I'm sure of that. But, you know, you still have to... Glyphs, not so much. I've just had so many magical experiences with glyphs, like them appearing right before my eyes, the message showing up and at my place. I mean, just, I can go on and on. Glyphs, to me, it's not an inexact science. I know what's going on with them. Well, isn't that perfect timing? I lost my train of thought for a second, so I turned the camera off, and guess what happened in that... minute between I just turned it off and now, a little rock came and hit a piece of metal bar over here, like ting, and I actually seen it roll after it hit it. So we've got our friends around here. But anyway, what I wanted to say is that you know, like the some of the stuff on the ground, like that looks like humans would do the same thing, like ceremonial circles and some of that stuff, and the structures and whatever. Like I said, that's not as an exact a science for me as the glyphs. But I will say one thing about what I found yesterday, the circles and the and whatever, is that, you know, I am drawn to go places. I get the energy and I just... thought placement, guidance, whatever you want to call it, to go places. And twice yesterday, I was led off trail, only twice led off trail, and both times I was led off trail is when I found those the stick circle things that are so beautiful and that are shown in this video. You know, the one area had like two of them. And the second area I was led to had a single one. But, you know, I don't believe that's coincidence. I know people who have been doing that for years. They're led someplace and there's something there for them. I guess, you know, and I've been doing it for a while, and it certainly happened yesterday. So many amazing things. And, you know, and it's just such an honor to go there. I mean, it could have been my guys too. Could have been my guys, because I mean, they can go anywhere. I mean, they've shown up in Portland and Seattle, and you know, I'm from the Vancouver area, so it could have been my guys, but I kind of thought it was local guys. And it was, you know, like I've always said, once they know you one place, they know you every place. So it was a cool experience, and what an honor, and what a heartfelt experience. You know, how to connect with Sasquatch, I think, you know, really start off with respect. Start off with respect. Respect them. Respect them for who they are, you know, for spiritual beings, for our people. And then after that, then the connection comes from the heart. You connect with them through the heart. That's the true connection. That's where all the knowing, all the knowledge, all the connection comes from love and that energy. So I'm trying to think. I think I pretty well summed up everything. Except, well, I'll just say that it was like I said, one magical day. And those kind of days are priceless and never get enough. So thank you to the forest people. Thank you to you guys, wherever you are, whether you're here cloaked, like I know you can do, and just ping that rock over there, or whether you're over there, or whether you, however you did it. Thank you for your support. And thanks to you guys for listening.
past the planet, looking for total view. I've been lying here for hours. You've got to make a journey.
Gifted a Sasquatch calling card, which is what I call a track in combination with a clef. And that's exactly what happened this day, as you can see, and it's a blessing, and it's a hammer over the head moment, and it's pretty cool.